I'm going to tell you something, though. I'd be kind of turned on if my if I came home, my wife and my sister were getting it on.
No, you wouldn't be.
I don't know. Although, I wonder if I could trust her. You know what I mean? But I don't care. I want something exciting to happen.
Well, see, when I walked in and saw that,
your wife and your
totally
sister.
Threw me for a loop, you know?
I'd like my wife to get into some lesbianism, but not with my
somebody,
sister.
With somebody, not with your sister.
Just maybe with my dad.
Oh.
Imagine you come home and you see your wife and your dad.
I can't believe my sister called you.
Yeah, why not?
Well, I don't know.
What? I'm such a bum, I can't be called, and this isn't my kind of situation.
Your sister sleeps with your wife. You shouldn't be shocked by anything.
Yeah, dude. Big deal.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
I mean, but try to picture it.
Oh, I can't imagine. Hey, take your sister to pick up the other phone. Get her on the phone.
Yeah, hold on a second, okay?
Wow.
This poor guy. Holy cow.
Go pick up the other phone. Don't be stupid. Are you there?
Yeah. You're pretty pissed, I can tell. You're yelling at her.
Yeah, he can't stand her.
Yeah, well, he's got every right to be, but...
Well, she didn't do anything wrong. She was sleeping.
Right. Hello? You there? Where's your sister?
I don't know.
Hello?
Hello?
Hi.
Did you talk to her about this at all? Have you said anything to your sister?
Well, I asked her. So what the hell are you thinking? This is my wife.
Well, why don't we talk this out? What were you thinking?
Yeah, I'm home wrecking, bitch.
Are you got? Do you want to apologize to your brother now?
I have apologized. I feel really bad.
You just got caught up in the moment.
Yeah, but that's my wife, you know, you homewrecking bitch.
What? Yeah, I don't understand how you could wake up with a woman kissing you and not say anything.
And it's my wife.
Was it good for you, though? Did you really dig his wife?
Yeah.
Oh, Jesus.
Would you like to be with her again?
No.
No?
Do you think you're a lesbian?
Well, possibly.
Oh.
Oh, God.
I can't believe you're letting your sister stay with you, but I guess that's pretty nice.
What are you going to do?
Yeah. Does he keep yelling at you and calling you a bitch like that?
Yes.
Doesn't that upset you? Or you feel guilty?
I feel guilty. I really feel guilty.
You don't.
Why don't you two get it on?
Oh, stop it. What are you advocating over there? You are the devil.
Do you ever want to get it on with your brother? Do you two have a dog?
Oh. Get him out of the house.
Oh, no.
Wow.
Well, you know, it's understandable why she would get on with my wife. She's a good-looking woman.
Yeah, she sounds really hot, 5'9".
Did you know your sister was gay?
You know what, Robin? I had the foggiest clue. I mean, I always looked at my sister as innocent, pure. I mean, I've beaten guys up for coming on to her. And I come home, and she's doing my wife. Oh. What the hell? You know? I mean, think about it.
I know. It's weird, man. But I don't know. I don't know. It's kind of turning me on.
Well, in a strange way, I imagine it can be kind of a...
Yeah, if you were listening to this story instead of being in it, you would see it differently.
Oh, yeah. I mean,
if you're listening to it from my viewpoint...
Exactly. If you see it like this, if you hear about it or see it on a porno or something, it's like... Ugh, you know
how long did the session last, my dear?
About half an hour.
You mean you had a half hour to think about this?
Right after you closed the door, they finished. They got into it.
God. Yeah, they never even stopped.
Yeah, they never
even
stopped.
Said anything about
they didn't even say anything to each other.
Serious?
Did you know this? Oh, you probably don't know any of the details.
No, I don't. Well, did you reciprocate, you homewrecking bitch?
Did you reciprocate and do something?
I thought it would make the matter worse if I didn't know about details.
Well, you may as well have. I found out.
God. Did you reciprocate? Did you do stuff to his wife?
No.
Yes, you did.
No, I didn't.
You liar. You know you did.
I didn't.
Liar.
You kissed her.
Yeah, you kissed her back.
Oh, that was...
Where else did you kiss her?
Exactly. You know you kissed her. Did you kiss her all over her body?
No.
Yes, you did.
Back. Liar. No. You're lying in my face. You're lying to millions of people. You know that, don't you?
That's right.
Has the sister tried calling you since she left?
Well, she pages me all the time.
I meant the wife.
Yeah, but has she called you?
No, I haven't talked to her.
Liar.
I haven't.
You know what? Hey, Howard, you know what's going to happen?
What?
I'll tell you what's going to happen. I'm going to go to work or another safety meeting so I can bring home the bread for my dumb bitch wife.
Right.
You know what's going to happen is my sister's going to sneak in and have this little affair behind my back.
Right.
You know, because, you know, it's like you said, you know, if my sick-ass perverted wife is going to do this with my sister, God knows what she's been into. I'm going to grab myself checked for AIDS, swear to God.
Yeah, you should.
I mean, because if she's that loose and immoral, you know...
Yeah, you didn't know she was into girls at all.
I had the foggiest idea. I mean,
hey, if the three of you want to come down here, I'll fly in.
What, are you going to do marriage counseling?
Yeah, we could do it on the air, like Sally Jesse Raphael.
You want?
Yeah.
If I can get a hold of my wife. Yeah.
All right. Wait, hold on. We'll get it lined up.
Is there any way this marriage can be saved?
Yeah, let's try and save the marriage.
All right, we'll see.
Jesus, pretty wild. No kids or anything.
Well, Howard, let me say one last thing before you throw me off the air. Have you ever been in a situation where you see, you know, two women getting it on with each other?
No, I've never been in that
situation. You've never
seen
that? No. I'll tell you what. I mean, I'm not homophobic, but to me, it just seems unnatural. And to see your sister doing it, man.
Oh, listen, man. Let me tell you something. I think it is an unnatural. I like it. I like to watch it. But I don't know how I'd feel about my sister and my wife getting it on.
Yeah, it's disgusting.
I hear what you're saying. But it is kind of sexy.
Oh.
I'd like to see these two.
Well, you know what? I've seen it in
porno. So she did you for a half hour?
Oh, God.
She did you for a half hour?
Yeah.
And were you wriggling around a lot?
Yeah.
Were you moaning?
Bitch, I'll bet you're proud of this.
Were you moaning?
Yeah, she was.
How do you know that?
He walked in and heard.
I put my key in the door, Howard, and I'm getting ready to walk in. I hear all this going on. I'm thinking, well, geez, somebody's having fun. You know, I thought maybe because me and my wife were into porno a lot. We got a big library.
Yes.
And I thought, you know, maybe she was watching some, or maybe, you know, or maybe my sister got into it, was watching it. And I walk in, and she's screaming up a friggin'
storm. You were moaning, weren't you?
Howard.
Let me talk to her for a second. Were you moaning?
Yeah.
You were.
Screaming.
You loved it, right? Mm-hmm. Oh, I got to meet this. I tell you what, man.
You know what I heard, Howard?
What?
I even heard her say, I'm close.
Oh, my God. Oh, all right. Listen to me. I'm going to put you on hold, all right?
All right.
Whew.
Was she moaning the words mommy?
Mommy.
God knows what was going to come.
But at least you two are talking. I mean, have you guys had discussed any of the details of this, or have you just been ignoring each other?
Well, I just asked her what the hell she was thinking. I mean, she's welcome to stay at my house as long as she needs to, but because she's my sister, you know.
Now you're going to be afraid to bring girls home.
Absolutely.
Your sister
will take
them.
Next time I get married, my sister ain't going to the wedding. God knows what they'll do.
Your sister must be hot, man.
Well, see, she got into it, right? She may come on to my next wife.
Hey, who does your sister look like that's famous? If you think of a face.
My sister?
Yeah.
Geez, I don't know. It's hard to say. I mean, she just looks like what I've ever seen before.
Do all your friends get it on with your sister?
Well, they all like her, but, again, she always turned them down. I always thought she was the nice,
clean girl.
Now she's a lesbo.
Yeah.
Now she's a lesbo. That's why she was turning them down. Now she's a slut lesbo.
She's Satan's favorite slut.
Yeah. All right, dude, listen to me.
Yeah.
Are you still there?
Yeah.
Miss X?
Yeah.
All right, I want to get you guys down here, okay?
Okay.
I'll straighten this whole thing out. I'll get you guys all straightened out.
All right, cool.
Because you guys need some intervention.
Yeah, we do.
And I can do it.
This
well, I'd
is
appreciate
a first.
It, Howard.
What? No problem.
I mean, this is just my family's dysfunctional. Period.
You guys want to come down to New York?
Yeah, sure.
All right. And you,
yeah. What is your sister doing living with you anyway?
Right.
Well, she came home. We had a death in the family.
Oh.
And
good Lord.
Too bad. She wanted to get it on. She wanted to get it on with them.
Yeah. Necrophilia.
Where are your parents?
Well, they live in the high desert.
Oh, I see.
So
trying to get away from you two.
Yeah, probably.
All right. Listen, do they know anything about this?
No.
Oh, good. Fly them in. Fly them in. We can put headphones on them and reveal it to them on the air.
If you want. I mean, my dad loves you.
Cool.
I'll be damned if he doesn't hear this morning.
Yeah, right. All right. Hey, hold on, you guys, all right?
All right, thanks.
I want to arrange for a family reunion on the show.
All right.
All right, Miss X.
Okay.
Baby. Hold on.
All right.
That's a sexy story.
What I did on my summer vacation.
That's a sexy story. Huh? Huh, Hartford? Aren't you glad we started it?
Just in time.
You would have missed that. A week earlier, you wouldn't have had that. That makes the drive to work much easier. That little home wrecking slut. My sister. I didn't know what to make of it until the brother got on, and then I believed it.
Yeah, then I believed it.
Yeah, me too.
Oof.
All right. The people of Hartford who just signed on with us this week, they have to be asking themselves, gee, what happens tomorrow?
Yeah,
I'm going to pass some wind into the microphone. First time
just
I've ever
to
done that.
Raise the level of the show.
Yeah, you know what? Let's get back to what the show is really about. I'm going to put my butt cheeks here, get the microphone. Watch. Yeah. There you go. Okay.
People were begging for farts.
That's what it's about.
Can't we get back to the farts?
Just we can't get back to the farts. Jackie.
Yes, sir!
All right, here is the winner of the Robin theme song contest.
All right.
I'll play his thing. He's going to come in and do it live, but let me play a little of it so people are all set for this.
Howard, I'm Robin's dad, and over 30 years ago, I recorded one of many great nights with my young, sweet Robin. So here, you all find out why I have hands, why she likes eye colonics, and why she likes it bent over in the third input. Cool, right? Wait. Robin, wake up, sweetie. Robin.
Your mommy's asleep. Take off your PJs. Daddy's coming in with the Vaseline. Your body's soft. Come and give Daddy a big hug and a kiss.
Is this what it was like when your dad did this to you? I mean, can you imagine? Because this guy really sounds like a child molester.
He does.
It's so
he
great.
He sounds like he's got it down.
Oh, my God.
Sweet talker. Give your daddy a kiss.
Robin, I'm coming in.
Welcome, mommy's gone. Take off your PJs.
Mommy's asleep.
Get the Vaseline.
Wake up, sweetie.
He's so good at it.
Your mommy's asleep.
He scares me.
He knows the routine, man.
When we was in the shower, your butt cheeks was warm. Still warm. Maybe it's a fever.
All right, let's meet
this guy. I can never get that line.
I don't know. What was it, Fred? What was that line?
Your butt cheeks is warm. Something about quiver.
Give you a quiver?
Yeah. I'll give you a quiver.
After touching you, my hands smell like ham.
Yeah, after I touch you, my hands smell like ham. All right, let me meet this guy. Why does he get weirder?
You'll see.
Is he really weird looking?
Let's just look.
Gary's got something up his sleeve.
Yeah.
What's going on?
Oh, wow. This guy's in a wheelchair. Oh, holy mackerel.
And he won a jet ski.
Oh, man. Are you completely paralyzed or something?
No, I'm not. Partially, it's just that the right side is kind of weak.
What happened to you?
Strap on.
I was on an accident. How you doing, Robin?
Good morning.
You know, he's not a bad-looking guy. He looks like that guy who got Madonna pregnant. Dunny?
Thanks.
Yeah, if you'd been rolling through the park, maybe you'd have been Madonna's dad.
You want to know something? The guy ain't a bad-looking guy.
No. Thank you. You either. You look pretty
But you
good.
Can't get laid, right?
Yeah, definitely.
Oh, you can.
Yeah,
but you're in a wheelchair, and it looks like your right arm is in a cast.
Yeah, it's weak.
Yeah, and what about
that's not a cast? That's like a splint.
Yeah, like a splint.
Now, what happened to you?
A car accident.
Oh, really? And now you want a jet ski?
So my right side is kind of weak, but I still exercise and do everything. You know.
Now, is that going to get better, or are you stuck like that?
Well, I do exercise. I do sit-ups and push.
I think he's messed up for life. Are you messed up for life?
You're not getting out of that chair, though.
I never lose hopes.
Oh, no wonder you're not working. Now I understand.
When did your accident happen?
I work, but, you know, I'm just a little freelance and, you know, some...
What's the toothpick?
I don't know. Get the toothpick out of your mouth, will you?
You know what happened?
What happened? Get that microphone near you. Jackie, help me.
I was a little nervous. So I was asking Joy for a few of some gum.
Yeah?
I gave me a peppermint toothpick.
I see. So wait, don't be nervous. Now, this guy is a genius. I don't know if he could ever create another great song. When you created this song...
No wonder you're sitting at home thinking of these sick things.
Yeah. Did you have any idea that we would be so into it?
No, because the thing is, first, I thought that the thing had to be here by the 6, and the 6 was you're going to announce the winner.
Right.
So I had...
You got it in pretty early.
Yeah, Friday, I wrote it.
Right.
Saturday morning, I read it to make sure that I fit the words into the song that was short.
Yes.
So I had to rush the words in.
Right. And you have 6 different versions of this song, right?
I recorded about 5, one on top of the other, because, you know, the song is, the music is short. So
right.
I had to read all the words to it fast.
Now, you haven't gotten laid since your car accident, right?
No, I got laid, the last time was about a year.
A year ago.
When was your accident?
It was about 8 years ago or something.
8 years?
You mean you've been messed up like this for 8 years?
Oh. Yeah.
And what were you drunk when you were driving?
No, it was just wet. You know, the street was wet.
And did you collide with somebody or just you went out?
No, I just hit a fence.
Oh, no kidding.
So you couldn't even collect any money for this?
No.
Oh, man.
It was the water. He didn't want a jet ski.
But after a year or so, you know, you get used to it and things are normal. I do everything.
You got to go on. What are you going to do?
Yeah.
Wow, 8 years and you still can't move your arm, huh? Holy mackerel, you really messed up.
I do pull-ups, all kind of things, you know.
Howard, you know, you met him before.
Where?
At Brentano's Books. You know, when you walk in, there's a bunch of wheelchair guys up front. He was one of the guys.
Oh, is that you?
You're kidding.
Oh, yeah, I saw you there.
I was the I was the first guy there.
Oh, really? Wait, here's a guy who wants to buy your jet ski. Hello, you're on the air.
I want to buy it.
Yeah. You want to buy it, Jackie?
Yeah, I got $300 cash.
$300?
Well, I call jet ski.
That thing is worth, how much you want to pay for it, sir? He's got a double jet ski.
Howard.
Yeah.
I'll beat Jackie by $900. I'll give you $1,000.
You know what?
$1,000?
I call Kawasaki and they told me it's worth between $4,000 and $5,000.
All right, it's worth $4,000 or $5,000, but I'll give you a G.
Well, no.
You want a G?
No.
Hey, Ralph, what do you want to say?
I'll give you $1,200.
No. Really?
Let's not have a bidding war here.
Hey, Jackie, what do you pay for it? You got money.
$1,500.
You guys are unbelievable. Give the guy $2,500. You got yourself a deal.
How do you know what he'll
You don't even want the thing. You just said you want
it. For $1,500, I want it.
Oh, of course.
Ralph wants it bad.
He
really?
He doesn't want to sit on his dock.
He's been asking about it. He went and researched it. He asked around to see what it's worth. Yeah. He really
so make the
it.
Guy a decent bid. The thing's worth $4,000.
Seriously, I want to look into it a little bit more.
Snooze, you lose.
Whatever Ralph wants to pay, I'll pay $1.
Snooze, you lose.
Probably like $2,000 or so. No.
So offer the guy $2,000.
What are you saying, man? No?
No, I'll wait for a better offer.
He's going to wait for a better offer.
Yeah, I mean, because...
Cash.
I
you ain't going to be on that jet ski.
No, because I need the money, you know, so...
All right.
Howard, I'm the guy that you didn't let in as a contestant.
So give
why?
The... Why?
Well, no, you actually played mine...
Yeah, yours was pretty good.
...yesterday.
Oh, you were the runner-up.
I was Robin's dad.
$2,500 go offer the guy.
$2,500?
Yeah, but if you want a jet ski...
It's a $5,000 jet ski.
How much do you want for it? Do you have a price?
How about four?
Four? That's what it's worth. I can go get one.
Well, I mean, no. The guy told me $4,000 to $5,000.
Well, if it's $4,000 to $5,000, yeah. Grand,
so there's how about $3,500?
Why don't you ask him for $3,500?
Yeah, that's good.
You know, somebody show up with four. You know, that's pretty good.
Yeah. Who's going to show up with four?
No, I mean, somebody maybe will. Somebody.
What if they don't? And you sit with a jet ski. What are you going to do with it in the ghetto?
Somebody really wants one or is ready to buy one.
Does it have a trailer?
You know? Yeah.
You know, because it's for two people, so he can take his girlfriend there.
Here's another guy. You want to buy the jet ski from him?
Yeah.
How much are you paying?
$2,000.
Come on. So, the thing's worth $4,000.
Yeah, well, it's used.
Yeah,
it's
right.
Used.
He's right.
Wait,
it's not used.
It's used.
You guys in a wheelchair. How is it used?
It's used. It's out of the showroom. It's worth at least
$4,500.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. These guys are heartless.
This guy can barely walk.
Advantage of it.
Have you ever? When's the last time you walked? 8 years ago?
Well, I can't stand to transfer and things like that.
You can stand?
Yeah.
I'd like to see that.
No, but I mean, it's just to transfer to get into car.
We got to prop him up and put him on the jet ski and film it for you.
Why can't you go on it? Can't you like get on it?
Yeah, Ralph. Why don't you go on it, you moron?
It's too crazy.
The guy's in a wheelchair.
Jesus.
Hey, you know what you ought to do? Offer him $4,000. Write him a bad check. He can't take it.
Yeah, I'll give you $5. Hold on.
There you go.
Yeah, give him anything.
All right, listen. All right, get out of here, please. This is ridiculous. Let's see. Oh, hey, Dominic's on the line. Hey, Dominic. Hello?
Yeah.
Yeah, how you doing, Dominic?
How much will you pay?
$3,500.
All right.
There's another guy who doesn't need a jet ski.
Yeah, Dominic.
South Island.
Really?
What are you going to do with Dominic? He's going to sink when you get on it.
Jason will love it for the summer. I'm still ready.
Hey, how about... Go up some more, Dominic. How about 38?
You got a deal.
Take it.
You want
all right.
It? 30, that's pretty good, man. That's really very generous.
And Ralph, you can use it once a year.
So, Dominic, you going to buy it from him?
Yeah, I really will.
All right, $3,800. Okay, there you go.
There you go.
All right, very
all right
good.
Thanks, man. Bye-bye. Nice meeting you.
What is your... You didn't tell us your whole name yesterday.
Outbid.
Oh, my first name is Euler.
And Euler.
My middle name, Bill. So, wait,
Euler,
in Spanish, you can say Euler.
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 Euler?
Yeah, but it's
Guillermo.
It's German, so it's Euler.
Euler, and your name is Bill?
My middle name is Bill.
Bill what?
Bill Soto, S-O-T-O.
All right, Bill Soto. Well, he's the winner of the Robin contest. You never molested any children?
Nah, man.
Because you sound so good at
this. That's what I see yesterday. You know, every child molested should be castrated, definitely.
Yeah, you are very funny, though, man. Do you have any other songs that you've ever written?
Well, the thing is, first, I didn't think you guys were going to listen to it.
Mm.
I thought never was going to get here.
You know who he reminds me of a little bit?
Who?
Christopher Reeve.
Oh. No, he can breathe.
Do you have a pipe?
No, but I mean, breathing through the neck. That's,
all right, here's what we want to do. Let me take a little break.
All right.
And you got to do the song live. Yeah. Okay, man? You promise?
Yeah.
All right.
I got to see him. Wait a minute. Do we have a little tape recorder that he can work the whole
thing? No. I want to.
The only thing, remember that I start speaking before the song
comes in.
Yes,
you'll cue me. When you point to me, I'll hit the music. So
do you know exactly where your music comes in?
I guess I would point to Howard, so he can play the music.
Right, but you know exactly where.
Hey, Robin, you should be in here while he's doing it. You should dance like an MTV video.
Robin, the thing is that yesterday you made a mistake because you said that I was slapping you around and I was knocking on the door.
Oh, that's knocking on the door. So I thought you were slapping.
So I was just waiting for your mom to go to sleep so I can knock on your door and go inside and see you.
With your ham hands.
Yeah.
He's setting up a whole scene.
This guy. Thing I've heard in a long time.
Thanks, man.
Yeah, man. Good job.
Thanks,
all right, good. And you just made yourself $3,800, so that's pretty good, too.
Thank God, because we only had a jet ski for you.
Yeah, I can't believe this guy won a jet ski.
Yeah, I know. You know,
thank God you entered the contest. When you heard it was a jet ski, we were like,
yeah,
oh, man.
Yeah, thought he'd have been discouraged.
No, because you asked me yesterday, I mean, I was going to use it when I was young, because I say, we'll see.
Right.
So I just didn't want to say, you know.
Yeah, I just thought you couldn't use it because you're like a Puerto Rican guy from, you know, from the Bronx or something.
And
or Yonkers.
Don't ever see water.
Yeah, there's no water in Yonkers. I mean, I just pictured it out in front of your, you know, in front of your tenement.
Yeah, because I just wanted to surprise you.
Yeah, right.
I just wanted to surprise you.
Oh, you surprised me, all right. It's like Christopher Reeve winning a saddle. You know what I mean? All right, dude, let's do this. Let me take a break. You can calm down.
All right.
Get your music out.
All right.
And get ready to perform what I think is the most incredible song. To see you do it live will be my honor.
All right.
All right.
It's my honor to be the master of comedy.
Thank you, Bill.
I was
who are you talking about, Fred?
Jackie.
No, Jackie. All right.
Why didn't we just give him a set of rollerblades?
Yeah, and let's film him for E.
Yeah.
I'd do anything to put you on that jet ski and watch you float around on that. All right, we'll take a break. When we come back, Bill will perform his award-winning Robin theme. You are linked to this man forever.
Oh, yeah. Boy.
His song is so brilliant. He plays your father molesting you.
Yeah.
And he does some job.
That's after going to Puerto Rico on a vacation.
Right.
And picking up the bad accent.
I see. Okay, here we go. When we get back. Wake up, sweetie. Robin's so sweet and cute.
Robin, your mommy's asleep.
Mommy's asleep. Now,
Vaseline.
Like what? What'd you say?
I'm coming in with the Vaseline.
Yeah, right, okay. Listen. We're here with Bill. He won the Robin song parody. Where is Robin? Robin ran out of the room. She can't look at you.
In.
Oh, she's coming in here?
I think.
She wants to sit here for the...
I thought she was.
Robin, come sit in here so he can sing it to you.
Yeah.
Come on, Robin. Are you afraid to look at Bill?
Come on, sweetie.
I don't want to look at him.
Come on, sweetie.
So dirty.
Come on, Robin.
Come on. He's such a nice guy. I'm in here talking to him.
He's a nice guy.
He is.
I'll come in after he finishes singing.
You got to admit, he's got some sick thoughts, though, to write this song.
Well, you know, I love women, you know.
Right.
I bet you do.
Yeah, I bet you do. You like young women?
It turned over.
Right. So, Robin, come in. He wants to sing it to you.
He
does.
We got. Sing it to me.
Come on,
here.
Please. Come on.
Please. He's begging you.
Robin.
He's such a nice guy.
Robin.
He can't get up and molest you. He's in a wheelchair. Come in here. Come in here, you.
Come on.
Get over here.
Why do I have to come in
here?
Sing it. Come on.
He wrote this for you. Come in here.
I just need to feel you close to me, you know.
Come close to him.
I can't come in there.
It's warm in the shower.
You feel your butt.
Your butt.
See, I can't even move my right hand right, so, you know.
After touching your butt, my hands smell
like
ham.
He wants to look at you.
So I won't be touching you or anything, you know.
Be a sport. Come on.
Go on. Come in here.
Sport.
Come in here. Be a good sport.
Look, this is not a song to be sung to anyone.
Come on, don't you want to get in here before we call Martin Lawrence over at Sherman Oaks Hospital? We're going to do that, you know.
I would come in for that.
All right. All right. You ready to sing? I'm sorry. Robin is uptight for some reason.
I'm
don't know.
Not uptight.
He wanted
I just
to sing
don't
it
want
you.
This song sung to me. I right. like it. This one.
Now, I know you're going to start with a vocal, just a cappella, as they say.
Recitation.
Recitation. And then when you're ready, just point to Fred somehow with that one good hand.
Yeah. I'll be ready.
Are you all set for this?
Yeah.
This looks very complicated.
Let him get set up. All
right. I'm just worried about a sound effect, Howard.
Which sound effect?
Because the thing is...
The knocking. I'll give him the microphone.
The knocking of the door.
There you go. You can knock
right here. Here's that. This guy's really well thought out.
Oh, he's really
right here.
Is that all right?
Just knock right here.
Okay.
right. All right.
Oh, boy. See, I can't even concentrate if I come in there.
During the live show, right. He was very, very concerned with the knocking sound effect.
Well, of course. Yeah.
He wants it to be authentic.
Yeah. All right, Bill. And by the way, Bill revealed something when he wrote this song. He was trying to do an African-American accent to be your father. And this is as close as he came. So you let me hear you speak like a black man. Just say anything.
Hey, Robin, what's going on? You don't look at me anymore, baby. What's up?
See? There
that's
you go.
His, yeah, right. So he, this is. Black accent.
Bill was inspired by the part of your life where you were molested by your father. He obviously must have read your book.
He was fixated, I would
say. Right. Yeah, because maybe.
You got it in paperback or you have it in hardcover?
I have it in paper. Maybe your father went to Puerto Rico and took a vacation at
right.
some time, you know?
All right, so now.
My father wasn't going anywhere.
He's, in a sense, playing your father. Your father never left the house. All right, here we go. Fred, you get ready on the button when Bill cues you.
Okay, right. So let me see.
Jeez, this is so complicated. It,
well, listen, perfection is... He's like the Beatles of molestation songs.
Glasses
on? Okay, get the microphone a little higher, Jackie, for him. Okay. Help me out, Jackie.
He keeps looking at Fred like...
He put it down so he could read how it is.
Yeah. All right, are you ready? Do you want to tell Fred your cue?
What's your last line?
What's the line before
line
you
line before the music.
The last line is, cool, right? Wait. When I say wait.
What
when I say wait.
If somebody held up the paper for you?
You want us to hold the paper up for you?
Yeah.
You need a stand?
Do
we
do that or you want to get through?
Why can't you hold up the paper?
Oh,
because he has to knock.
Yeah.
Right
here. How did he do this at home?
I don't know.
We got 50 people helping him here.
I had the paper... I have something on my lap, the paper on top.
Who worked the tape
recorder? Can you just do the goddamn song before I throw you out of here? I don't care that you're in a wheelchair. Just get it done. I thought the handicapped know how to do stuff.
Yeah, we do everything. Sex. Everything.
All right, go ahead.
The bitch.
Start the song. I'm getting fed up with you.
Hold on. All right, so I'm getting ready, right?
All right. You're,
go so ahead.
Get ready.
After the way you start.
Okay.
All right.
Howard, I'm Robin's dad, and over 30 years ago, I recorded one of many great nights with my young, sweet Robin. So here, you all find out why I have M-Mans, why she likes iColonics, and why she likes it bent over the sink in the third input. Cool, right? Wait. Robin, wake up, sweetie. Robin, your mommy's asleep. Take off your PJs. Daddy's coming in with the Vaseline. Your body's so soft. Come and give Daddy a hug and a kiss. When we was in the shower together, your butt cheeks was warm. Still warm. Maybe it's a fever. After touching you, my hands smell like ham. Okay, baby. Getting all four. I want to grease you up. I need to grease up your butt to check your temperature. You have a fever and make it all disappear. Oh, yeah. Daddy loves you. You'll grow up with big jugs one day. My Robin, so sweet and cute. Three input babe, then and now. Unconsciously reenacts my abuse. We are colonics and loving and of sex. Bent over the sink, Daddy loves you.
Wow. Wow. And I heard stuff that I didn't hear in the original.
I did too.
Like, you have
make
a fever.
It all disappear.
Yeah.
Yes.
You make your fever disappear.
There were things I couldn't catch.
All right.
I guess it was in the original, but I guess you guys didn't hear it.
No, it was hard to understand, and now it was much clearer. Wow, and here's the lyric sheet, Robin, that I have.
Yeah,
I hope you'll autograph that for me.
How did you type that? On a computer?
I said to on the phone yesterday, I'm a graphic designer.
Uh-huh.
And I do business cards. I do birth certificates.
Birth certificates?
Yeah.
You make up birth certificates?
Yeah.
Doesn't there, like, the government or something?
Wait,
it's not a legal birth certificate.
It's just like
Like cute pictures with the baby in the middle,
right?
And the information.
Very nice. And what do? You type with your nose?
Oh.
No, I use my left hand pretty good.
Do you?
Yeah, I did something for you last night.
What did you do?
Is that his book?
Well, yeah. The thing is that I ran out of color, That's my portfolio.
I see. Yeah. Well, you've done some
that's
beautiful things.
That's my resume,
things,
business cards.
Wow. Very
kind of
nice.
Things.
Very nice stuff.
So that's the birth certificate right there.
Oh,
and
beautiful.
The loose paper is the one I did for you.
Very nice. Very nice.
Well, do you want to give a number or something?
It looks like he's building
business?
Up to a plug.
Yeah, I'm a.
Here's my birth certificate. See, yeah. Beautiful.
No, that's a read it. It's
oh.
a it's
oh,
a
how gorgeous.
It's an award.
Yeah.
Yes. Thank you. Well, thank you.
You're
what do you
welcome.
Want me to do?
Yeah, you know, if anybody needs a business card,
give the number
or any 914-423-5456.
The guy actually does beautiful work. Yeah. Does really nice business cards.
Thanks.
Unfortunately, we're not in business. And he's scarier than De Niro.
They can work with you by phone. They don't have to see you.
All right, Bill. Congratulations on the jet ski. I guess Dominic has bought it from you.
Thanks
and that's
a
good.
Lot.
And thank you for writing this brilliant
thanks,
song parody that will live in show history.
Thanks to see you also. I just want to say hi to the people in the Bronx VA. Ray, all the guys there from Diva. The girls, you know.
No offense, I got a show to do.
Kind of
I don't know. He's rambling now.
See you all. Thanks a lot.
Write a song about it.
All right.
Now we need you to roll on out of here. So, Bill, we'll stay in touch. And if you ever come up with another great song, would you please send it to us?
Definitely.
The great Bill.
Yeah.
Nice meeting you all.
Nice meeting you. This guy thinks
bye.
He won an Oscar. He's not gonna,
bye, Anna.
He's making a speech.
Nancy
all right.
and everybody.
Who's Anna?
Anna is a friend. Nancy, Margarita,
mis avios
Francine.
De pesca en la cocina?
Francine,
muy bien.
Nice friends at the VA.
At the VA, you were a vet?
No, he's drinking
yeah.
V8.
Oh.
Yeah.
Are you serving Vietnam?
No. I just served a couple of years in the Army.
You did?
Yeah.
You're a good man. I like you.
Thanks.
All right. That's Bill, everyone.
You too.
I would have served, but had a trick knee. All right. We'll be back right at...
one more thing, Howard.
Yes.
Do you remember when...
Can I get out of here, Bill, or what?
Gloria Estefan, she said she wanted to send you her panties. She never did?
No. Thank you, Bill. He must have written that last night. I told you, this guy's a one-trick wonder. He wrote that song. I think that's the last one he's got.
That's the last funny thing he's ever going to do.
All right, Bill, we love you.
All right, thanks
Thank you, man. That's the great Bill.
Yeah. Bye, Robin. Bye. I love you.
And now, why don't we play Robin's intro so she can start the news.
And now here's Robin Crazy with the news.
No, that is not James Brown, Robin.
That always disarms me.
Right. My sweet Robin.
Sweet and cute.
Your butt cheeks. Your butt cheeks are so warm. Bend over.
With the Vaseline.
Get the Vaseline.
Loving anal sex.
You have a fever. I have to take your temperature.
Why don't you bend over, my sweetie? Daddy's here. Your PJs.
Wake up, sweetie.
Wake up, sweetie.
Your mommy's asleep.
Nobody can do it better than Bill.
No. Bill's the man.
Hey.
Robin, look how pretty my legs and feet are. Thank you. Let's show you that.
You won an award?
I won an award. Aren't they sweet and cute?
So sweet and cute. Your legs.
Well, we're not nominating the rest of your body, just your legs and your feet.
Ivan Reitman called me last night and said, I'm definitely going to get an Academy Award just based on the stuff he's seen.
Has he ever gotten an Academy Award?
No.
No.
He wishes he could get one.
Very good.
I wish she'd become an alcoholic and drink herself to death.
Dear.
Hey!
Well, that's not a nice thing to say.
That's true.
You're not known for nice things, are you?
No. Every minute I say something that's not nice to say.
A 6-year-old San Francisco area boy charged with attempted murder of a 6-week-old child may soon get to leave juvenile hall. What is the stumbling block? Finding a suitable foster home. Now, Howard... You have plenty of room.
I don't. Actually, I don't. I want a new house. I want more room.
Can you imagine? Oh, yes, we have a foster child we'd like to place with you. Oh, yes, tell me a little bit about the child. Well, he just kicked a 6-week-old within an inch of his life. So would you like to take this child?
I'd rather take a baby tiger into my house. How do you think of that? I think the kids would stand a better chance of survival.
The boy's lawyers are requesting that he be released to his mother, but that request has been denied.
Yeah. I say give them to a pack of wolves and let them raise them.
The attorneys say the boy is suffering emotionally in custody.
I see.
They feel that he'd be better off at home. They had a bunch of protesters down, I guess, at the courthouse yesterday saying that this child is being portrayed in the media and being treated by the court system differently because of his ethnicity.
Ah, that's probably it.
The boy is said to be the youngest child in the nation ever charged with attempted murder. He's accused of breaking into an apartment and beating a month-old baby nearly to death.
What ethnicity is he, since we didn't know?
The doctors say the infant is in fair condition but will likely have permanent brain damage. This was a normal baby until this little kid got a hold of him. I heard one of the protesters saying that everybody knows that a child of that age doesn't know what death means. So he wasn't trying to kill the baby.
Wrong. Trust me. That kid should be executed. There's no hope for him. Watch. He'll go to court. He'll bite the judge on the thigh, ripping his flesh. I've met kids like him. I've counseled kids like him. As you know, I'm a trained counselor. And there's no hope. His personality is already formed. One's personality is formed by the age of two.
Two?
Two. That's my counselor voice. Two. That is correct. You think you're the only one who could be fancy and put on airs? They should put him on an electric merry-go-round horse because he's so young. So at least he'll think he's on a ride and he gets his juice through his little body. That's right. Oh, look, a ride.
That is your best.
Here, come here, Junior. You're going to get a ride for killing me, almost killing me. There you go. You should put that kid in a room with me and I'll kick him to death.
And then you can say you didn't know it.
I didn't know it either. I thought he was... I give him an exploding candy apple. What'd you say? I don't know what he said. An angry what?
A hand grenade.
A hand grenade in the apple, right. There you go. Thank you, Jack.
I know this doesn't affect you, Howard, but...
Nothing affects me. I'm soulless and heartless.
Almost one in three American adults is worrying about making ends meet. Just a year ago...
That's why Jackie makes CDs in his basement.
Women are also more downbeat about the economy.
It's true. Vaginas throw off your reasoning about financial matters.
Stop it.
That's a proven fact, and Robin has just pointed it out.
Oh, dear. No. Sociologists say that the difference is due to the lower earning power of women. Very simple, Howard. It's not vaginas.
Sure. You don't know that for sure.
Sure.
You better be careful. Back.
Wait a second. Michael Buffer wants to say something.
And now, ladies and gentlemen,
let's get ready to smell each other's farts.
That's great. All right, never mind all this nonsense. I'm going to talk about reality. But talk about Vietnam.
Reality?
A lot of you punks out there.
Vietnam is over, huh?
Not for me, it isn't. It's never been over. My good buddy Tony's here. Tony now works a restaurant business. This guy's a real Vietnam vet.
As opposed to
these guys who walk around and they say they're in the army, operation
like...
this. This is a real man.
Like
this
you?
Is a man. This is a man. Look at him.
That guy was in Vietnam?
Oh, yes, sir. That guy was in Vietnam.
He looks considerably older than you, Howard.
Well, he went through hell, this guy. He took bullets. How's it going, Tony?
Okay, how you doing, Howard?
All right.
How are
you? This is a real Vietnam vet. Tell Robin the years you were there.
1969 to 1973.
And you see his arm? That's where he got shot by the gooks.
Oh,
look at that.
You took a gook bullet, right?
Two bullets. One is partly in there. I'm a little slightly paralyzed over there, but I still do my job. No problem.
Yep. The man can work.
Right.
He never came back here and asked for a favor.
Nope.
When they spit on us, when they did all this to us. Right?
That's for sure. Never did nothing for us, that's for sure.
Still, you're damn right.
Still asking questions.
You're still asking questions.
What are the questions?
What are the answers? Tony knows.
First, tell me the questions.
Tony, I don't want to bore you with my stories right now. I'll give
Please.
You those later. But
okay.
What years were you over there?
69, 70, and 72. Wow.
How many tours did you do?
About 15.
15 tours of duty. That's right. That's a man.
Wow.
I've done three, and I thought that was a lot.
You didn't do all 15 in Vietnam.
Oh, yes.
Oh, yes.
Matter of fact, in the same area.
Wow.
Right near Hanoi. Oh, yeah.
Oh, my goodness.
Now, Go ahead.
One of my stories are... Yes.
Is I had a blow up. I was a demolition expert.
Now, by the way, let's tell everyone, Tony, we use words like gook because when Tony was over there and I was over there...
That was the word, the gook.
That was the word. Now, listen, we know... Please, Robin. Please, just go along with it. When we was over there, there were guys, we had to dehumanize the enemy. Now, I know today...
Now, who told you to call them gooks?
That's something we knew. You knew when you went over. When we were in country.
That's what was happening when you got there.
Why did they call a word like kamikaze?
Right. It's just a word.
Yeah, that's what it was.
It's just you understand, we had to not look at them as people. Let me ask you, John, how many kills?
How did you get all into the psychology of it?
You are forced into it. Either you become an animal.
No, some people just do it. You are all into the psychology of what it meant.
Because it's all we talk about. You sit around with vets too, right?
Right, all the time.
Really? Oh, yeah.
That's all I associate with is vets.
Is that right?
Yeah, I lived up in the woods for 3 years with
vets. Where do vets go? Because I never see any.
Well, we go to singles bars.
Right.
But seriously, how many people did you kill?
Maybe 150.
How do you know that?
Well, I mean, it's an idea. I mean, here's what it is.
It's a guesstimate.
Okay. It's the same idea Howard has.
No, hey, let me tell you something. I'm going to ask you a question. I'm going to tell you what happened to me in Vietnam. I'm over there. And we're just out doing our thing. We come across this village. I see a schoolhouse. Kids, women, you know, everything. I say, I'm going to blow it up. Because that'll count as like 100 people.
Course.
I blow up the whole schoolhouse, and I know I must have killed 100 people because I was counting the little fingers and toes.
Yeah, right.
They count that as one person. Right? What happened to you over there?
Did anything like that to you?
Of course.
Taking away your kills?
Well, I killed about 50 generals.
How did you do that?
Okay, and they were their children in a compound.
Right.
They were all living there.
Yeah.
Right. They had like 30 kids. Now, the idea was I didn't want to kill any kids.
Yeah.
Sure you do. There's nothing wrong with it.
Excuse me, you know, talking.
Those VC grow up.
You know it. They're going to out to kill you.
That's right.
Out of the 150 women, 150 that I killed, at least 30 of them were women.
Don't feel bad about it.
Coming out of the trees, boobs and all.
Boobs and all?
With M16 guns.
I think he and you M16 were in the same
guns. Let me ask you something.
Let
me ask you, when you blew up those mamasans, you knew they were VC.
Of course.
You blew them up.
How could you tell?
And you saw their breasts blow off into the air?
Right, of course.
Of course.
How could you tell they were VC?
Of course you could tell.
When you fall off a tree, you should see how they look when they hit the bottom.
You know what they're VC.
I think he was in the same Vietnam. Now, you now convinced me he's in the same Vietnam you were.
This guy's the real deal, man. He knows.
Oh,
I don't
man.
Have 108 stitches for nothing.
Yeah.
Excuse me, I've seen car accidents that do that kind of
damage. Hey, Tony was over there, man. Don't no. give me this.
I should have brought my medals, you know.
Yeah? But, how many medals you got?
I got about 9.
Yeah?
Yep.
What do you got there?
I got a silver star and a blood medal and a purple heart. Well, I was hurt, you know.
Yeah.
Right.
You know.
We called them gooks. We called them slopes.
Yep.
Whatever we had to call them. What'd you call them?
Gooks. Same thing.
Gooks, right? Yeah. When you got shot, you were like, oh, my God.
So did
gook.
You go on any of those retreats?
No.
Those R&Rs?
No,
I did.
No, I never. No.
You never had a mama-san? Let me tell you something, Tony, what you missed over there, because I had the time of my life sometimes. Once I look back on this finally. $2 a month. I had a girl.
Oh,
her daddy sold it to me.
That's right.
She would sit there. She would do my cleaning.
That's right.
She'd give me sexual favors.
Right.
And I owned a brother on top of that. For
$2,
$2 a month, he'd do yard work. Swear to God. $2 a month,
and
Tony.
Landscaping.
I had it made over there. You never went on, you never had any mama-sans?
No.
What are you talking about?
Nope.
No kidding.
No.
How did you go?
Hey, he's an old man. He ain't no homo.
I just didn't do it.
Yeah.
My job was very important.
And how did you deal with your sexual urges?
I did something else.
Right.
Ah.
Hey, me too. I did plenty of that too.
We all did it.
Nothing wrong with that when there was no mama-san around.
That's right.
And right there in the foxhole.
Oh, yeah. Did you have a gook ear necklace? I had one.
I had one.
You did too? Yeah. How many years did you have on your necklace?
About 2 years.
2 years? It's nothing. I had 17 years on my gook necklace. Yes.
Wow.
It helped me hear better.
What else did you take over there?
Hey, Tony, tell Robin why you got false teeth.
Well, when I was captured.
Yeah. You
he
were
was
captured?
Oh, yeah, he was captured.
When I was captured,
oh.
They put me in a regular camp.
Get on that microphone, and Tony.
They put me in a camp, and they put razor blades and rusty nails, and they tied my mouth up with all tape.
Oh.
So
they started to work me over.
Oh.
And when I got back to the service, I was...
Your mouth was all messed up.
Oh, yeah, I had my teeth taken out.
All of them.
That's right.
That's why I never...
32 of them.
That's why I never felt bad every time I blew up a village. Well, Let me tell you about the time I blew up a village. It was one guy survived. I took him. I buried him alive. I left his arm sticking
hanging
out of
up.
The dirt. Hanging out of the
popular.
Dirt.
Right, that's and, right. Out of the dirt.
And I let him wave goodbye. See? See what I'm saying? I did that.
Should I tell you the duck story?
Tell Robin. She don't know anything.
About the duck,
completely
Robin.
Naive. Yeah.
When I killed the 50 generals, there were about 20 children in that compound.
Uh-huh.
Now, I had to get the children out.
Right.
Instead, I didn't want to kill the kids.
Uh-huh. Yeah, I did. I killed plenty of kids.
Right? I did, too. But
yeah, all right. But you don't like to do it. All right.
I had made some...
You want to know something for me?
Made some wooden ducks.
It's more fun blowing up kids. I'll tell you why. The arms and legs go much further.
Oh.
You blow up a school, the body parts make a nice snowflake from the air. I don't care. They were going to kill me.
That's right.
If they're going to kill me,
that's right.
I'll kick their ass.
Could you let
Tony... Let me tell you something, Tony.
Tell me the duck story.
1 second. I'm on a roll. I love blowing up hospitals. You ever blow up a hospital?
Of course.
Of course.
Four hospitals.
I blew up one. You got me there, pal. The wheelchairs and the beds become missiles and kill whoever you miss. So, listen to this. I blew up a hospital with about 50 survivors. They're walking out. The wheelchairs fall on their head and kill them. I'll tell you something. You ever cut open the belly after you kill a man?
Yep.
I did, too. I cut open their bellies.
Why did you do that?
It's great fun.
It's interesting. See what goes on.
Right.
Really?
You could learn about your enemy. I like
how do you come back here and then turn into a regular human
you
being
do it.
Who can walk around without cutting open a belly?
You put
have
it
a
behind
good mind.
You put it behind you, right?
That's right. Everything is behind you. You know that.
Yeah. You know what I would do? I would yank out the stomach. I don't know about you. Did you ever do that?
Yeah, of course.
I would yank out the stomach with my left hand while I played the Three Stooges and gouge both eyes with my right hand.
I thought of Abbott and Costello.
And did you ever bowl with their heads? Of course. Of course.
Oh, dear.
I used to cut off gook breasts and take turns wearing them to give my fellow guys boners.
I wish Tony had brought in some documentation besides his Park Lane T-shirt.
Hey, Tony.
Well, hey. I've been there 17 years.
Hey, Tony.
Yeah.
You ever cut off the breasts of the gooks?
No.
And then put them on your chest and parade around for the other guys?
I never got that.
I did that. If you were with me,
I had the opportunity to do that.
My buddy.
I wish I would have met you over there.
Oh, I would have loved to. We would have had a good time. I'll tell you something, man. It was showtime when I would put on those breasts. All the guys loved it, because I'm very feminine looking. I am. I admit it. I'm feminine looking. I got a curve to my body.
You're a beautiful man.
I'm a good-looking man. I make a good-looking girl. I was in drag back then.
It's all right.
I'll tell you something. I kept a gook vagina in my refrigerator for emergencies.
In case of one, right?
Yeah, well, if I didn't have $2 for a broad. You know
you
what I'm saying?
There.
I had gook.
$2, a candy bar, I thought you said.
Sometimes you don't have money out there in country. You know what I mean? How'd you escape from the POW camp? Tell Robin.
I broke one of the soldiers' necks, one of the gook's necks.
Really?
Go ahead. And then what'd you
with
do?
With your bare hands?
That's right. I hit his neck, and I snapped his head, and we escaped. It was like about about 10 of them at the time.
Really?
We got out of there.
Did you kill the nurses, too?
Two nurses.
Super.
And one doctor. Stabbed him. I took both of them. I killed both of them.
No kidding.
Well, what'd you stab him with?
You're a real hero.
I had to kill.
What'd you stab him with?
With a pick.
Oh, my.
Yeah.
A goddamn pick.
That's right.
All you pussies out there sat on your ass. Jackie, goddamn trick knee.
Bastard.
You got trick knee draft dodger.
I respect you, Tony.
Yeah, so you better.
Had to be done.
Thanks for protecting me, because I got laid a lot while you were over there.
Yeah, right.
I thought about you guys. Don't worry.
Let me tell you something. All these guys sitting around having a good time while we're busting our balls, and we come back here.
Do you miss it?
I miss it.
No.
You
well, are? Sometimes.
Have you ever thought of going back there just to see?
There's plenty of guys still over there. There's about 4,000 or 5,000 still in caves.
You're damn right, and nobody's helping them.
Why aren't you over there getting them out?
Because we did our job.
Yeah, I don't
ever kill on weekends.
I don't want to get into that.
I've killed on weekends, but I didn't have to. It became a psychology with me. I don't know about you. So tell. So you got out of the POW camp. Tell her about the ducks.
Well, when I had bombed a compound.
And they were like 50 generals. I had to get these children out. So I do a lot of woodworking. So I had made some ducks.
Go ahead.
Little fake ducks, and I put them in the water.
Yeah.
Ah,
right?
Yes,
and all smart. The kids looked at the ducks, and they all ran out. Then I set my C2 and C3. It was all over.
Hey, let me tell you, that's nothing. I was up on a plane with a friend of mine. We're bombing a rice paddy. Me and the other guys are up there in the plane. We play tic-tac-toe in the rice paddy. You believe this? We blew them up, but we would do zeros and X's.
Yeah, right.
That's how we played. But the best thing with the broads over there, that always relaxed me. I'm surprised you didn't take advantage of that. You couldn't tell the cute slope broads from the ugly ones, so they were all pigs. Who cared? I preferred having sex with the ones with their heads blown off. Have I had sex with
oh,
you?
No.
I did it.
Pretty good. That's pretty good.
Dead women?
Oh, yeah.
It's different.
I blew this one girl's head off.
What's that? Necrophilia.
Yeah, I had sex with her.
Necrophilia.
I had sex with her head.
Necrophilia. Yeah, he remembers her.
That's right.
Yeah, no body but a head.
She was still warm. It's a different... she don't understand what it's like over there. You become a whole different man. It's a test.
Right.
To test it. No one says war is fun, but if you're going to be over there, have some good times, too.
Oh, jeez.
I'd hang the women live from a tree upside down. Cut their arms off.
Now, what do your other buddies talk about? Do you sit around talking about stuff
sure.
like this? Your kills and everything?
Of course. What'd they feed you in the POW? Tell us what you learned.
I don't want to tell you.
Tell her.
No, I know it was dirt rice. Dirt
they
dirt
put
rice.
Dirt in your food.
Dirt.
Of course.
Of course.
Dirt. Ugh.
Unbelievable.
I was very lucky when I came back. I found a good man that gave me a job right away. I've been with him for 17 years.
Thank God for him.
You know.
Mention that man's name. He's a hero.
Eddie Weinstein, the best of all. Park Lane Gourmet.
Eddie Weinstein's a good
that's
man.
Right, the best.
He didn't turn his back on us.
Nope, that's for sure.
Turned his back on me, but...
I met him in the street, and he said to me, I'm looking for a good man. I'm the man. You won't be sorry.
Of course.
Gave me the job. I'm still there.
You're a decent guy.
That's right.
You're on the air.
Yeah.
It's me and my buddy... Tony.
Yeah, you and your buddy Tony?
Yes.
Hey, this is Howard, right?
Yeah.
Okay, look.
Is this a real Vietnam vet?
This is a real Vietnam vet.
Hey, what are you talking about, real? Tony, she's saying we're not real.
Yeah. Hey, come on, man. Hanoi?
Yeah, well, how much action was in Hanoi?
How much action was in Hanoi? That was the capital of North Vietnam.
That's right. Well,
so?
What was going on
so
there?
So what, you don't
what
think
was Tony
action?
Doing there?
There was tons of action, right,
there
Tom?
Was action. No,
there was action. No,
what are you
there
talking
was action.
About?
Hey, Way City, man. That's
hey, man, you want to see this guy with bullets in his arm? You tell me if there was no action.
Hey, he lives in New York, he's got bullets in his arm.
What'd you say?
If he lives in New York, he's got bullets in his arm.
You know what, man? You're a coward. You should have gone over to Vietnam.
Hey, come on, man.
You weren't over there, you pussy.
Yeah,
what was your unit, Tony?
My unit? I was in the 1st Marines.
What was Tony's unit?
I was the 1st Marine, too. Yeah, I like this guy.
Yeah. Tell him where you were.
Where in Vietnam were you?
Simplify. I was in 66, 67.
Did you ever hear of the Ranger Division?
What Ranger Division?
Did you ever hear of the Ranger Division? Right.
It's the Army.
Did you ever hear of the Ranger Division?
Yeah, the Army.
What was it? What scout was that? What number?
I got a friend named George. He was over there.
Yeah, you're a lying dog. Goodbye.
Thank you.
Goodbye, you pussy.
Yeah,
hey, keep laughing. The guy wasn't over there.
Well, he would
Let me tell you something, Tony. We lived through it. A lot of our guys didn't make it back. But we at least keep the names alive.
How? You never said one of them.
Well,
we would.
Let me tell you something. A lot of people didn't respect what was done.
Right.
Over there, that's for sure.
Yeah. I did.
You'll get telephone calls from now to doomsday, and nobody respected anything that was done.
Right.
And I respected it.
If you're not a vet, forget about it. You don't even know what you're talking about.
Exactly.
I'm a vet. Did you know I was a vet?
Where were you?
I was in
She was in a hospital.
Patterson.
Right.
That ain't no vet.
Oh. Trying to get out.
Now, let me tell you something, Tony. You're a man to be admired. You survived. You did what you had
you
to
had
do.
Had to survive.
They didn't know. No. You went over there. You weren't the son of some senator. You weren't the fortunate one. You had to go serve. Lieutenant Calley is the man, and I don't care what anyone says. He did what he had to do. Screw everybody.
Do you respect Lieutenant Calley?
Of course you do.
I just wanted to ask the guy. Why are you screaming at me?
Of course. He was hung out to dry by this country.
Why did you guys not say something then?
We did. No one listened to a bunch of grunts. What's wrong with you?
What was your rank, Tony?
Lieutenant.
Oh, you were an officer.
Yeah.
Of course.
By mistake. Yeah, well, have you heard of George Custer? George Armstrong Custer?
Yeah.
You know his mistake. He became a general.
Right.
Well, this was my mistake. They gave me orders, and I was a private. I became a lieutenant by mistake.
Hmm.
That's impossible.
Oh, nothing's impossible.
Hello, you're on the air.
Yeah, how you doing?
Yeah.
I'm calling in about this guy here. He says that he was in 15 tours of duty.
That's right.
Well, 1 year is a tour of duty.
Right.
He was there from 1984. From 69 to 84, he was there.
There's some dirty tricks going on over there.
What'd you say?
There's some dirty tricks going on over there.
Let me tell you something, man. You ever been shot? That counts as a tour of duty, and you go back.
15 years. Whew. That guy's putting in the time.
Hey, listen, man. Let me tell you something.
He was there after the war ended.
He's still there. I don't know what your point is, Chris.
Well, you know what my point is, Howard?
Were you over there?
My older brother was over there.
Oh, your older brother.
Yep.
Oh, so what does that make you? That makes you a pussy.
That makes me the guy who realizes that Jackie is the talent on that show.
Jackie's nothing. Stupid ass. Jackie got nothing going on. The draft dodger.
I should have brought my ID in here.
Hey, do you believe this?
Well, you gotta question 15 tours of duty.
Well, you see this character here. He's just going by what do you call that? Speculation.
Right.
You know,
he studied the war.
In other words, if you hear that, and you have to blow up say five buildings or five. We're talking 5 years. We have to do this.
Uh-huh.
You can do it all one at a time. We're gonna have to do everything one. Could do everything just as it goes by, and that's it.
Uh-huh. Of course. Listen, Tony, we don't have to justify
anything.
You don't
have to justify yourself to anybody.
Tony, can I just say you're a hero? You're my hero. You hear what I said?
You're my hero.
All right, well, that's all I wanted to say. I wanted to bring in Tony.
Your old buddy.
And my old buddy, talk a little Vietnam. I feel good now. I don't know about you. I like it. One of our buddies wants to join in on the conversation. Should we let him?
Go ahead.
All right. This guy was over there with us.
Who is this?
Ronnie.
Ronnie.
Yeah, how you doing, Howard?
Hey, Ronnie.
68, 69, 7 to the 17th Air Cav, 2 Corps.
Excellent.
You remember that?
Of course.
What Corps were you in?
The Colonel Corps.
The Colonel?
I was in an Elite Corps.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You were in I Corps, right?
Apple Corps.
I hear you.
Now, listen, what do you want to say? How many kills did you have?
Well, I'm not confirmed. I didn't have that many confirmed.
Get off the phone
now. No, no.
Didn't have any kills.
Oh, goodness. Another real Vietnam veteran shot down.
Oh, please. Yeah, Tony, these guys didn't have any kills. Good today. Standing over there probably on a boat, swabbing the deck. Swabbies. You know what I'm talking about?
They weren't there on the ground like you guys
in
Hanoi.
You talk to guys who are on the ground. Get it? That's Tony.
Thank you.
Over there, Park Lane. That's why I always go to Park Lane, because
of
Tony.
Of course.
I don't care what's
going
on.
Supporting your Vietnam brother.
Damn right. We'll be back after these words. Do you love that sound or what? With the guns?
Darth Vader.
It's fantastic. Give me more guns. Oh, I love it. I miss it. Those were the days. Right? Hit the deck.
What deck? You're on land.
Oh, that's right. I was confused. Thank you. Hey, Busta Rhymes.
Hey, Mr. Stern.
Yo, 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 what's up? In the house.
Yo, I got Rampage, the last Boy Scout, on the phone with me.
Yo, 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 what's up with that?
What's up, man? What's going
what's
on, man? We love you, baby.
Love you, man.
Hey,
what's up?
Are you going to say any more than what's up?
What's up, Black Guy Star?
Oh, yeah.
Hey, man, you know what I'm saying.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, we know what you're saying.
I'm just trying to... You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
I know what you're saying. You know what I'm saying? Hey, by the way, you guys speak black real good. Not as good as me.
I think you speak black better than we do, though.
Yeah.
I know what you're saying.
Hey, now. Yo, in the house.
So what does the reference to Howard mean?
You know what I'm saying? Hey, do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, what you say? We're going to tell you what we were saying.
All right, what were you saying? All right, by the way, Busta Rhymes has a new album out.
What's it called?
It's called, what is it called?
The Coming.
The
man
Coming.
Man Page, you're going to hold it down, right?
Right
check
on.
Check it out.
Yo, know what you say. Check it out. Coming, man. I know what that is, man.
All right, that says a lot, man. We're going to let you know what time it is right now.
You know what I'm saying?
This is the deal.
Right.
Busta Rhymes released the album March 27th
and Busta
on Electric Records.
Busta Rhymes is bad.
All
right. Right, you know what that means. That means good.
Yeah, yeah, all right.
When you say something negative to a black man...
It's opposite.
That's opposite.
I see.
Man, what about when you say something negative to a white man?
Right, no, that's a whole different thing,
oh,
man.
Oh, my God.
Okay, watch this. Let me impress these guys. Watch this. I'm going to speak some black to these guys. Right? Hey, man, you is dope. You is dopes.
I think you doper than all of us.
Yeah, man. Yeah, hey, hold, excuse me. You stupid idiot.
You're the dopest.
you're full of crap and you're nuts.
You're the bomb. And you're crazy.
You're lower than urine.
And you're the lowest of the low.
Yeah, right.
Style.
Your whole family is the lowest.
And your grandparents and your ancestry is the lowest in the lower.
Right. I know what you're saying.
I know what you're saying.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
In the house.
No doubt, Mr. Okay. Stern in the place.
All right, now.
So you talk about calling the nigger Howard Stern.
Now, hey, thanks for calling me a nigger. I'd like that.
Yeah, you were honorary nigger.
Right.
No,
I'm down with that.
No question. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I know what you're saying. What do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I know what you're saying. Do you know what we were saying?
Yeah.
Howard keeps saying nigger, and you guys are saying nigga.
No, nigga. I'm a nigga.
You're a nigga. No, wait. Check it out.
All right, check it out. I'm going to play what you said.
All right, play it.
Here it is. Check it out.
Yeah.
You remain endless. My victory remains flawless. Acting like you rap, but I know you really heartless. While your time is coming, I make the fact shit regardless.
Many niggas want to know when the brand return. Yo, I'm getting phone calls from that nigga Howard Stern.
Yeah.
No doubt.
Know what I say? No doubt. Hibbity. Let me rap for you a little bit. Let me rap for you. Here, give me some rap music.
Hit me one time, Howard.
So check out my rap. Here's what I have to say. You know what I'm saying?
What you say?
All right, here I go. Check it out. Check out what I'm saying right now.
All right,
here I go. Give me some music, goddammit. You know what I'm saying?
Uh-oh.
All right, here I go.
Better be good. Come on. You better make it right, too.
Here I go, man. Hippity, 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 hop. A bibbity, bibbity, a bibbity, bop. A jiggity, 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 jig.
Yeah.
Bibbity, bibbity, bobbity, boo. What do you think of that?
I think that was kind of like some old newness that you just invented and added to the whole hip-hop community.
Now, what were you guys saying about me? I explain what it means.
All right, check it out.
All right.
Well, me and Rampage, the Last Boy Scout, made the record, right?
Right.
And when we was making this record, we were just talking about how, you know, we blowing up the spot to the point where, you know, we trying to bring it to the levels.
Right.
That the world got to get to the point where they trying to figure it out in every aspect. Even
yes,
Howard Stern.
Yes, sir.
Word up. So.
Word up.
We felt, you know, being that we like Howard Stern.
Uh-huh.
Let's incorporate Howard Stern.
No doubt.
With the whole impact of how we trying to approach that song.
You guys smoking weed this morning or what?
Nah, man, we just was up early because we preparing for the video shoot that you got to come to this weekend.
Hey, let me ask you a question. No doubt.
No doubt.
Yeah.
Listen to me. I want to thank you guys for putting me, first of all, in the song. That's always
no
very...
Doubt.
And I like to be called a nigga because I am a nigga.
All right.
You understand what I'm saying?
No doubt.
You know, I might be a white man, but I was always treated like a nigga.
Yeah, I hear that.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Right. So, you know what I'm saying.
Yeah, I know what you're saying.
So that's what I'm saying.
No doubt.
All right, I'll see you guys.
All right, check it out.
Everyone go buy the album, Busta Rhymes. All right, my man.
All right, Howard.
All right, those are my brothers.
Yo, Howard, man.
I'm down with that.
Check it out, Howard.
Peace out.
You guys ever kill anybody?
Nah, man.
That's not cool. That's not cool.
You make fat, yo, Howard.
How you going to sell records if you don't kill nobody?
I think we did it very well because the album is 890,000 copies sold. And the single is platinum.
You guys getting white women yet?
Oh, man, we getting the international scale of women.
No doubt. No doubt.
You know what I'm saying? But we keep it loyal to the family, baby.
You guys got illegitimate kids?
Oh, yeah. I got a nice 3-year-old son, baby.
Yes, sir.
And nice 2-year-old daughter.
Nice.
By two different women?
Nah.
Oh, nah.
I got my own woman, and Rampage got his own.
Word up.
All right.
Word up.
All
right. I'm going to rap to you now. Let me say something right now.
All right, cool.
All right. My mommy's on welfare. My poppy's on crack. Oprah Winfrey eat 100 Big Mac. Sammy Davis was a talented brother. And everyone in town has slept with your mother.
Oh.
How's that?
Oh.
Come on, man. I didn't mean to diss you.
Hey, yo, let me hit you with a rhyme.
Go ahead.
All right. Check it out as you get down tonight. We gonna hit you with the flow that's gonna make you feel right.
Right.
Yes, I show the world that we only concerned.
Sir.
With the lyrics that comes from the mouth of Howard Stern.
Sir.
Yes, and we now continue to keep it live.
Live.
You know we talk rhymes and we don't talk jive.
Jive.
So everybody in the place, you better keep in the room.
Room.
Room. Boom. And everybody stay tuned.
Cool.
What am I hearing, an echo?
Yeah.
Yeah. All right, Robin, you echo me.
All right.
Jesse is a lowlife.
Life.
Brothers want a white wife.
Wife.
Sharpton is a fasso.
Yeah.
A big march, don't go. Don't shoot, don't steal. Robin's birthday is real. Right on.
No doubt.
All right, you brothers, I'll see you.
Take it easy, Howard.
Right on.
Make sure you try to come down to this video we're shooting this weekend.
Absolutely.
Nice.
Peace. Peace.
Peace.
Peace in the Middle East.
Peace in the East of the Middle.
All right, thank you, my brother.
Take it easy.
That's Busta Rhymes, everybody.
Peace.
All right. These guys are insane. Those are dopes.
You got to have a guy. Why doesn't Ralph do that for you? Ralph is always hanging around. He doesn't echo.
Peace. I need Mr. Echo. Isn't there a guy named Mr. Echo?
Rampage.
Yeah. That was dope.
No doubt.
Yeah, I'm a nigga.
No doubt.
You see, I'm a nigga?
No doubt.
I don't mind.
No doubt.
Mm-hmm. No doubt.
No doubt.
No doubt.
That's what he says every time.
Yeah.
No doubt.
Why don't you do that for
no
me?
Doubt.
No doubt.
No doubt.
Yes, sir.
All right, why don't I take a break? Your Dice is on the satellite.
No doubt.
Ooh. I'll take a break. We'll talk to Andrew Dice Clay.
Dice.
Jackie's friend.
Yeah, Jackie wants to yell at him.
Yeah.
You ready this time, Jackie?
For what?
To yell at Dice?
Sure, if he yells at me.
All right.
No doubt.
No doubt.
No doubt.
Pussy. Hey, you and Jackie are not on the best of terms, that's for sure.
What's going on?
Dice.
Yeah.
Remember
why you put? You don't even say hello.
You're getting right into it.
Yeah, you just want to get into it, you know.
Dice does a funny routine on his HBO. What is that, tonight?
Yeah, no, not tonight. Tomorrow night it premieres at 10 p.m. on HBO.
Dice does a routine.
When's your special, Jack?
Oh, it's right before it. I'll be in Baltimore tonight. I got a couple sold out.
He's at Slapsticks.
Doing fine.
So what is that, like a coffee house?
Hey, Dice, I'm going to be in the Howard Shipp movie. I'll drop you a line and let you know what it's like to be in a good movie.
All right, good. I'm glad he's giving you enough pity that he'll throw you in there and give you a bone.
You want me to give Ivan Reitman a message for you?
Yeah, all right. Look, all right, I'll tell you what, Jackie.
We call you here, Dice? We call you Lice because we can't get rid of you.
All right, I'll tell you what. I'm going to give you 3 minutes to just do the best you possibly can.
All right.
No,
all right,
I'm done.
Ready?
I'm
one,
done.
Two, three, go.
All right, Jackie, go ahead.
All right, well, where are you ready, Jackie? The time's running. It's ticking away because when it's over, so are you. Go. You got your 3 minutes. You're now down to 250. Go. Well, where are you? I got to tell you, last time you were apologizing.
You still hired guys to laugh at you and tell you you're funny.
I let you off easy last time, Jackie.
You know what? Now that I'm doing better, I got in shape.
Because you apologize.
Can you blow water out of your back, Monstro?
Your wife does that a lot better than I can.
Go ahead, start with the CDs in the basement. You can't fit in the basement.
All right, I'm going to keep quiet. Go.
Go. You couldn't keep quiet with a gun put to your head. Fake Italian in real leather. Just the opposite of Buttafuoco.
I forgot. You're Jackie the Jew hater. I forgot about that.
No, just you.
Jackie the man that hates Jews. The next Marge Slot. The next Brando. Jackie the Jew hater. Forget about Jackie the Joke Man. Jackie the Jew hater.
So this comeback's going to be
I think that's the problem, Jackie.
Man.
You're pushing the issue now, Jackie. It's
Oriental,
a touchy
Dice.
Situation.
Jackie Buddha.
See, it's not about the Italian thing.
Shecky
it's just
Buddha,
how much
Oriental
you hate Jews.
Private
that's
eye.
Your problem. And then you get how many faxes came in the next day with a
well,
little
Dice.
Stupid...
Yeah, Dice,
you
say,
lose weight
no,
if
you
keep yelling,
to get
Dice.
Into
don't
this, how would I get into it? So you get a million faxes, right, saying what a jerk off the joke
biggest
jerk
radio
after I destroyed you. What happens? All these faxes come from all over the country. Jackie, you're a jerk off. Jackie, stand
so
up
So is this
yourself.
The final
then
no
the
win tour
call
or what?
That was taken was from like some 350-pound
Dice, you're over like eggs in a grease house.
How much did you pay the guy to call you, huh? How much did you pay this guy to make believe he actually admires you? Was he a friend? Was he a friend, Jackie? Just tell me.
Why is he, Dice? You said you were going
to let... You don't have friends.
You were going to let Jackie...
Maybe he was one of those retarded cousins you have, huh? Maybe he was one of those half-fag drinking buddies. What'd you promise him? One in the keys to Jackie?
What was that,
you
Lice?
Got a problem with me? Talking about a big fat ass. How's your mother, huh? Still working the truck stops Eh? But even she was smart enough to send me a letter apologizing.
I guess that
for
guy was right.
Did.
I guess the HBO special
my son
was pretty lame.
It's really not my son. He was a mistake.
My mother?
It was something that happened. I just wasn't willing to do it
all
that night.
Is that how they thought you say mother
so
in Hebrew school dice? Mother?
Yeah, you're very good. You're very good.
I owe Silverstein.
Is it true you're a pedophile? I mean, that's just something I heard, but I don't want to get into
Jew.
That. Is it true that you got a sideline job at McDonald's
Fat
and your wife had you get that?
Fat
you're the janitor in a McDonald's.
Fatso and Weber.
That's one man's
Weber
opinion.
Weber looked better on the cow.
That is one man's opinion. We'll Fat see so. Tomorrow night who's so Life. Fat. You're the only guy I know that tries to grow hair like Bon Jovi.
I know somebody sort of take it. Said, hey, that
come
looked
on,
like
Jack, you don't come
father.
Up against me. You're Howard's pity case.
Fat
you're
so.
Howard's personal
pity case.
Pot belly
I'm funnier in my sleep than you are when you've
bourbon,
got your boys laughing at you.
Boring, bedwetting, wrinkled up, old pot smoking, wet bed. When did
I
you
I got to tell you, you're reading better than you used to. You're reading
you're,
better.
With your corroding fingers, you can't get the dirt from between those wrinkled cracks in your face from all the bourbon you've been drinking.
With take a breath. Your heart's going to stop.
You
want
to talk about me bald? You're combing it from your ass up over your head.
Cholesterol must be right around my SAT scores, Dice.
This situation, it's a touchy situation.
Now, Dice.
Don't push the issue.
Now, Dice, you said you were going to let Jackie talk for 2 or 3 minutes.
I gave him the chance, and he didn't say nothing. He's a dope. He's a nitwit. He is the dumbest. Why does he even call himself a comedian?
And if you hang up, I'll be here talking
CDs,
to millions of people while you're home beating your head against the wall wondering what went wrong.
And his wife around. The panhandler.
Switch personalities
his wife,
again, you phony bastard.
The breadwinner. You're
pick another
Jackie,
nationality.
Right,
pick another heritage. Pick
seconds.
Another
go.
Name. Pick
go.
Another religion.
Go.
Why don't you spin the goddamn wheel and find yourself a decent heritage?
This is the best you had. I gave you a month to come up with stuff.
Try
and
Chinese.
This is the best
try,
you could do.
Try Godhead.
Let me tell you something. Let me tell you something.
Andrew Dice Haji.
Let me tell you something.
Paint yourself yellow and come out
this.
And scream.
How's
and
the pup? Puppets in concert. The puppet
a tough
makes
Jew. That's an easy sell.
My wife is jealous that the puppet
a
became
Jewish
bigger
bully.
Than you.
That's
how
believable.
How the puppet's funnier than you,
I'm Andrew Dice
how
Clay.
Come
I'm a
the puppet
tough
is
Jew.
Funnier than you? Does the puppet have a fan club? Because I want to join. How do I get to meet the puppet? The puppet who
Dice,
took
nobody
your
knows
rat,
what
Jackie,
you're talking about.
And made it funny. That's right.
We haven't had the puppet out in months. We know
said,
when it's over,
we
Dice.
We need a real comic on this show. Forget about Jackie.
We know when it's over.
We got the puppet. The puppet. That little cute.
I gotta apologize to you. I blinked and missed your TV
hair.
Show. What happened?
Cute little puppy. I blinked.
It was over.
I just want to see how fat.
I can hear your hair. Listen.
You
I heard your hair falling out. Listen, your hair.
Wait a second. 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 Why
you
didn't you guys? Wait.
Are you
wait a second. Hold on a second. Hold on a second. You guys. Wait. Dice.
Shut up, Howard.
Exactly like the puppet.
Dice.
People ever stop you?
Excuse me, Dice.
The people ever stop you in the street?
You know,
say,
you're so
you
redundant,
exactly
it's hard
like
to stay
puppet,
awake over
only
here.
Only a lot dumber.
Say mother.
Do you ever argue with the puppet? Are you waiting
dumb.
For the...
I'm
I think
dumb.
You're jealous of the puppet. It's not me. You're jealous that the puppet...
So why don't we get on stage together somewhere sometime?
Go
ahead. Let's get
man,
on stage together.
You. The puppet is
you
the game
big, fat, bald moron. Let's get on stage together.
You're jealous and you can't wait...
If one more person comes up to me at a show and tells me how much funnier I am than you, I'm going to get bored.
Can I talk to
oh, Jackie, we had to sit through Dice's show? He sucks.
Don't
you're funny.
What
the hell are people doing? Your CDs are funny.
Hold it, hold it.
Down
hold it, hold it, hold it.
Christ.
Hold it a second.
Lice.
You guys are yelling.
Beg to get on the phone.
No. I'm turning
it
down. Wait a second. Hold it.
You don't like the
hold it. I'm turning it down. I'm turning both of you down. I'm turning you both down. Dice. Jackie.
A pig. A walking pig you have as a manager.
Why don't you go put a mox in your yarmulke?
The way you're jealous that your wife's going to come up to the pig. You're
dumb.
Jealous that the way the pig would rub up against the always ready, always waiting.
Wait a second. Wait a second. Can I say something? Can I say one thing?
You're yeah, sure. What's
yeah,
on
okay,
your mind?
Listen. Dice.
Hi, Andrew.
Yeah. No, Jackie.
Andrew.
No.
You're both the puppet and Jackie.
No, you're talking to me.
Oh, okay.
You're both making points, but you're yelling over each other. Jackie Dice gave you an opportunity to say
yeah,
one
but he
thing.
He didn't say nothing.
Well,
I
let
him
say one thing,
time.
And then you respond to it.
I said everything I had to say.
All right,
yeah,
so
what
Jackie,
he's saying is speak one at a time.
Why don't you CDs sell? Why do you keep pressing CDs? I'm wasting the few.
All right, now let him answer.
Minimum wage.
Now let him answer.
I Allied Digital pressed them. I've sold 50,000. I'm selling
50,000 over 20 years.
That's all right. 19,000 were in the last week, guys. How many did you sell last week?
Success. You want to come? You see, I wasn't even. even going to fight with you today, Jackie.
You know what somebody told me the other night at Choice?
Wait, listen to Jackie.
You know what they told me? We got Dice's CDs. I said, really? He's like, yeah, we use them as coasters.
That's okay. The only reason I'm bringing this up again, let's come down to a human level.
Even though you look like the accordion,
you could at least try to. Yeah, I'm a big star. Tomorrow night, baby. It ain't you on HBO. It ain't you. You'll never be.
Don't tell your jokes to your money. That's the only person that's listening.
Giving them your tape. $35. They don't even want your money. They won't even put you on. They go, Jackie.
I went to rent Career Smasher, but it was out. I think someone recorded Seinfeld over it.
Listen to me.
That's your problem, Jackie.
I don't know. You guys don't even listen to each other.
I never saw Ford Pierland. How was it?
You're the only guy that takes old jokes from old joke books and puts them in a new book and puts his name on it.
Meet me on stage. Anywhere, Dice.
That's why Howard can't push
you. You want to share the stage sometime? You haven't got the balls to get on stage with me. You couldn't shine my sneakers.
You're a talentless person, and you just won't face the music.
Listen.
Be happy Howard let you be his one.
I'm the greatest radio.
Touchy situation.
He lets me sit here 5 days a week, Dice. He lets you on the phone for 1 minute and then signals Gary that we better get off because it's getting old.
Right. You're still sitting there jerking yourself.
You know what? People said Dice was great, but it kind of makes us miss Steve. Now I forgot his name.
You forget everything. Frosty. That's why you can't perform.
You know how close you are to Steve Rossi?
You got Alzheimer's already.
All right,
Same size, same baldness.
You are a very, very stupid
person. Oh, he's actually Italian.
All right. Listen.
Let's stop the fighting.
Hickory Dickory Dock, your time is up on the friggin' comedy clock, my friend.
Yeah, okay. Well, that's tomorrow night on HBO for an hour. The greatest special ever, and you're at a coffee house in Baltimore.
All right.
I got two sold-out shows in
Slapsticks. I don't even think people pay it. They go, there's a six-pack in the back, Jackie. Go ahead, drink it. Yeah. Drink it, you half a faggot.
Yeah, there'll be more people at my show than will see that piece of crap on HBO,
guys. You're used to that. You're used to bending over.
All right.
Just sitting there and taking it, never knowing how to give it back. I give you a month. I thought you were going to be a challenge. I beat you worse than I did last time.
All right.
You have no idea how bad you sound.
I'll stand there and bitch slap him for you, Jack. And you're, would you do that for me?
Listen.
Now, I don't want to fight with you.
Everybody's sitting there laughing at you?
I don't want to fight with you.
Yeah.
All right, listen, you two.
So when's your movie coming out?
You two are really going at it.
Really?
I was going to invite you to come into my basement to watch them make CDs, but you couldn't fit.
You know, I'm going to enjoy your movie.
Right. And for breakfast, Dice and Chevy.
Giving him a little break. It's not going to mean anything.
I know. All right, listen, you guys are both my friends.
You know, they're going to have to shut the lights
off. Maybe on stage, Dice. Name a stage. Name a time. Name a place.
All right.
Go ahead, Dice.
All right. Okay.
I'll blow your doors off.
You've been doing terrific up to this point.
I have.
You are real good.
I am good.
All right, Dice, you are on HBO tonight.
No, not tonight.
Tomorrow night.
It'd be funnier if you tune in tonight.
You see, I'm going to let you get away with it because that's
because
the first
you haven't got anything
thing
to say.
I've
you're
heard
too
you
hungry.
Say in the 20 years of comedy that
my
you're
theory
in
is you ate your hair and it made you Italian. Is that what happened?
Okay,
Checky.
So I don't have that much hair. I agree with you.
I know,
and I decided not to go with the wig, and I just wore it the way it is, and you could have fun. But you know something, from about the 30 or 40 million I'll make just off this special, maybe I'll get some plugs put in too.
Right.
I don't know. What do you think?
You know how you're going to make 30 or 40 million off the special? If you take
grow
a tape
you're
of it
the
and beat the bank teller over the head with it
but
and rob a bank. 30 or 40 million. How?
What are you saying, Jackie? How is he going to make money with it?
He takes a tape of it and beats a bank teller over the head with it. 30 or 40 million.
You're killing me now.
30 million yen, maybe.
Somebody. I am here with
play
somebody
it in
else.
Tokyo.
All right, guys.
Jackie, I know you're trying to save face, and I almost was going to let you, but you're too easy to destroy.
You got so much face now, I don't know if you could save yours.
Let's see the facts.
You want to do good on your HBO show? You know what you do? Use your
Jackie,
forehead for a
you
billboard.
Ever talk about
walk around LA with the HBO special
like
advertised on your forehead.
Beagle.
That is the
how
size
can you talk
of Nevada.
About any other human beings looks. Right. I know I'm handsome. I know I'm well built. You look like
you
a
you must have Coney Island
beagle
mirrors if you
think
you look good.
The problem is that you know your own wife has been trying to get into my drawers since the day she met me, and she looks at you, and you know what she says when you're coming towards her?
What is that, Andrew?
Ugh.
There you go.
Ugh. Ugh. I got to do this again for him to make him feel like he's any kind of man.
How do you spell yolk?
You look like one of these old guys walking around with a colostomy bag on the side.
Dice.
You're going to go play the coffee house? You're going to read out of your joke books tonight?
I'm 48, Dice. I look
30. How many joke books have you written?
You're
40. How many joke books have you stolen all those jokes from and put your name on it? I want to know that, Jackie.
I make
it. When are you going to become an original comic? When are you going to have a career?
You want to see me?
When is that going to be a time I say,
I
got to go see Jackie the Joke Man.
I'll look better, I'll get more laughs, I'll be wittier, and your sorry ass will be dragged out of there.
If you had a thought in your head, it would be lonely. Don't
you
understand? You can't win.
Is the fat in your ears, or is the hair in your ears, or is the spaghetti in your ears? Meet me on stage. Name a place. Put the audience
Jackie,
in there. I'll
you're
do
just
going
to have to get publicity your own way. You can't use my fame to get your own publicity. This is
if
as
I want to use your fame,
get.
I better have called
understand?
A year or two
this
ago,
This is as
Dice.
Much publicity as you're ever going to get. So enjoy this.
I'm here every
Unless,
day.
Wait a minute. Can you calm down for
did
30
seconds?
Did
I have seconds? To call to get...
For
get,
30 seconds, if you
calm
down.
Did I have
down.
To beg to get on this show?
Seconds,
no, I sit
Howard.
Here every day.
Howard, you got to
every
be...
day. 30 cities of 20 cities.
All right, let Dice...
Yeah, see, that's the problem. You're on in 30 cities every day, and you're playing coffee houses. Do you understand?
I'm playing a fantastic
club in Baltimore.
I'll
be doing stadiums from one court to this show. Could you imagine if I was on 5 days a week?
You
that wouldn't be
somewhere.
Places big enough.
Go ahead.
That wouldn't be places big enough,
TV
Jackie.
Show.
Your wife would say,
do
I'm going to manage
TV
him.
Show. Why
your
don't you call
the manager,
the Edsel?
Your mother, what she managed to do, just turn you into complete crap. You are crap in a toilet. You're the garbage that sticks to the side of the toilet. Don't you ever open your mouth to me. I could do more for you in one night than your stupid ass wife can do in your entire career.
Andrew, we're in commercial.
I don't care if we're in commercial. It's a touchy situation.
You thought about it.
All right, he did. All right, Jackie and Dice are not getting along.
Andrew, I love you. You know.
No, you don't.
No, he does. I know he does.
He does?
Yeah, and I absolutely have. Are we on the air?
No.
No.
Right, we'll
yes.
talk about this when we come back on the air.
All right, now we're on the air.
How do you know we're on the air?
We've been on the air the whole time.
Well,
I don't know.
You would if you were here,
air.
But you're not here. You're yelling to a microphone on the other side of the planet because you're not allowed on the show.
Of course he's allowed on the show.
Oh, I thought you were backing me up here.
No, see, that's the only reason, because forget it. Forget right. I don't even want to fight no more.
All right. Dice?
I'm not even going to work yet.
Dice?
But I do want to say something to you, Jackie.
Go ahead.
I do. And you got to keep quiet.
All right, say it.
And it's not going to be nasty.
Right.
It's not going to be nasty.
Okay.
You see,
what's
last time you didn't get the shot, I thought you could have been quicker. You weren't. You were a little more prepared this time. I got to give you the respect and the credit.
I was just... I
so
was...
what I'm going to ask you now
yes.
is only because I really do believe you're a talented person. I'm coming into New York. I got a concert I got to do.
Yeah.
And I want you to be the featured act in that concert, if you want.
I would love that, Dice.
All right.
Well, that's very magnanimous.
Now I'm going to call my manager, Rory Rosengarten. We will negotiate.
No, I'm serious with you. If you want to do this, I want you to be.
Yeah,
I
but
want
you know,
you
Jackie has to be paid.
I've asked
Dice?
Him before.
Dice?
I've asked him before. I wanted him in Vegas with me. He couldn't do it.
Dice, I'll do it for free if I'm free. Unfortunately, I'm booked solid on this hit movie.
You see, you can't even be nice.
No.
I'm asking
I said I'll do it for
we
free.
We have to fight.
When is it? I'll do it. I would love to do
it's,
it.
It's Town Hall. It's going to be a... When is it? The 21st of June or the 22nd?
He's busy.
Oh, stop it.
All right, if he's busy, he can't do it. I'll just book someone else.
Okay.
I try to give him a shot. He
no,
can't
no, you know what?
Me.
I actually am free the 21st.
All right, so then maybe
it's
Jackie...
the 21st of Saturday?
No, 22nd is a Saturday.
That's when we're doing it, the 22nd.
Well, you know what? If I can cancel my gig, which I'm not sure if I can because I'm making like $300 or $400.
Oh, now you want me to beg you to open?
I didn't say beg. I said I'll try and get out of my gig.
Now I got to freaking beg the guy.
I have to be you.
Guys.
I try to be a nice guy here.
Guys.
I got to be faithful to the coffee shop.
He's touching the situation with a pushy thing.
Guys, let me say something.
All right, you
say.
Be the mediator for a minute. Would you please?
Let me say something.
I'll do your show and I will help.
I don't care. I don't care about any of this. I don't care about any of this. I just want to give you your plug. You are going to be appearing on HBO tomorrow night in an hour-long comedy special.
Is it's an event. How can you just say it like
that? It's at 10 o'clock at night, right?
How can, yeah, but you got to say it the right way.
It's the return.
This is not like any comic. This is me.
This is the return
of Dice Clay.
This is the return of the Dice Man.
And it's a powerful one. I seen the show.
Right.
And you're going to look silly if you pick. Well, don't pick on me now because I booked you.
Right.
What did he say?
I don't know.
But no, you want to do that gig? I got to know if you want to do that gig.
Yes.
Yes, he does.
I would love to do it.
And if you want to fight on stage that night, if that'll make you happy, I heard the faxes. You weren't happy about it. I think the people that do dig you will be happy. You at least came up against me this beautiful Friday morning.
All right, so there you go. So Dice,
you know,
this was basically an audition.
Do you want to do Florida too, which is the night before?
Yeah, you know what? I could do that, but I don't think I can do the Saturday. But I'll do.
You got to do them both. Get rid of the Saturday.
Work it out, guys. Listen. Dice, thank you.
I gotta
go break for commercial.
Break for commercial and we'll talk a minute.
No, I gotta go.
What do you mean you gotta go?
I'm worn out from you.
I'm up 5 in the morning.
Howard,
I didn't
Gary,
even talk to you
Dice,
today.
Your HBO special just canceled. They're gonna rerun Karate Kid.
Yeah, I don't think you see?
There you go.
Right, I'll let him get away with that one today. He's a nice guy, you know.
Hey, Dice, thank you for calling in.
Dice, I didn't mean to call you fat and bald.
It's
you're
okay
because
I'm not either of those things. But if that's your opinion and it makes you feel better, that's okay.
Hey,
and no
I've
matter
known
what's said from
time.
This point on, we could fight. You are still doing this concert with me. If you want to do both, you're welcome
Very
to.
Very nice. Dice, and we'll all.
Personally.
Dice, we're all going to tune in and watch you on HBO
right,
tomorrow
Howard,
night.
You know, now we're talking figures here.
I'm going to watch you tomorrow night, okay?
Tomorrow night, HBO, 10 p.m. Assume the position.
All right,
Andrew
Dice Man.
Dice Clay to return. Do you understand that?
I understand.
Don't push the issue.
Thank you.
All right, I'll talk to you guys.
Tell Take care, Dice.
Tell your friends that we said hello when you're giving them their paychecks.
All right, that was good. That was funny. Whatever that means.
Andrew Chubbsy Upsy Clay.
All right, you want 30 seconds to go. I'm still
no,
giving
I'm
you
done.
The gig.
I'm done. I know when
you're
I'm done.
You're going to feel very stupid.
That's
when
the difference between me and you is I know when I'm done.
Believe me. Believe me. End it now. Or punishment will be due.
Gunsmoke is more
All right. Ill. Yeah, all right.
You're the sea hunt of comedians.
He doesn't stop. He's got open his mouth, and then I'm going to get angry, and then I'm going to stop.
Now
stop
I heard
yelling.
The next HBO
you know,
special. You're actually going to light the cigarette.
Is that true? Did your wife get you this gig at Town Hall? Did she book you there? No, I did it. Your wife.
You mean my wife,
you
Nancy Sirianni, who seems
your wife
all
booked you in
up?
A Chinese restaurant and coffee house. Your wife is the provider. That ukulele playing idiot. See, Tiny Tim had a better career.
You call my wife an idiot.
He did. I heard him do it.
My wife did something. An idiot.
Yes.
Do you understand that? Fabio.
Get to know
and he's got nothing to work with. Fabio.
My wife
no
is gorgeous
Green
and talented.
Does you in comedy. And you want to open your mouth.
And one of
I'm
your legs
you
weighs more than my wife.
I'm going to say, all right, I take back everything I said about that. Big.
You better,
so don't
you need something to
no,
say at the next
take it back. And even she's smart enough if she knows that
at least
there
I parade my wife
fighting.
Out. Yours
this
is hidden.
A comedic fight.
Where do you hide your
this
wife?
This is a comedic fight.
I think your wife is Hot Tub Johnny.
Well, that's one man's opinion, and I'll have to accept that. And at times,
you're not really Italian,
Johnny
maybe
is my
you're
wife.
Not really
and
hetero,
I love Johnny
either.
Very much.
Are you saying that Dice is in a heterosexual?
Well, you know, if the heritage is fake and the name is fake, maybe all the macho is fake.
Are you getting into that
Jew
hating
thing
again? Don't
you
get into the
Jew
hating thing. Don't get into the
Assume the position. Assume the position.
Okay, Marge Martling. Okay, Marge Martling.
All right, you two.
You hear that? Wait till the JDL gets
talk about taking a half hour to come up with a line. I can hear everybody's brains melting over there.
You don't open up about all the people
open
that
up.
Are better than the Jews.
Bend over
no,
and open up.
Just pick on the Jews.
Bend
just because I'm good looking and my nose don't come out 4 feet long don't mean I'm not allowed to be a Jewish person and have a bar mitzvah and say the full. I did the full question. My kid said, why is this night different than any other night? So you know what I said?
You was, I maybe said, you were funny.
Shut your mouth and eat the matzah.
Why is this night different?
Me.
Than any other night.
Do you
Andrew
hear me?
Said something funny.
Jack, you can't hurt me. We know how funny. I've sold more albums than anybody in history. I've played bigger rooms
coasted.
Than anybody in history.
Coasted.
You play coffee houses. I'm giving you the shot, Jackie. You better not bomb it.
All right.
You bomb it.
He'll be there, he said.
I'm going to haunt you for the rest of your life.
All right.
You're going to be backstage doing more drugs than Sam after you got to follow me,
balding,
pal.
Oh, my God. Did you hear that? You don't even hear what Jackie's
drinking.
Saying.
I love
you don't
you,
even hear it.
And you hurt me.
All right. Okay. You don't even hear what he said.
I say put on a dot for your next HBO special.
All right, listen, I'm going to let you two guys go. All right, thanks, Dice.
Jerky, I got to talk to you.
Jerky. Did he just call him Jerky?
No, Life. That's a good name. Jerky Life. The Jerk-Off Man.
Jerky.
Jerky the Jerk-Off. Yo, Jacob,
go
that's
have
what
your
I
fish
think.
Breakfast.
Your mother.
Your mother.
That's what I got to... Your mother wrote me that note.
How do you
he
say that in
mistake.
Yiddish?
I didn't want to take it in the yapper that night.
Hey, Rabbi Clay, how do
that's
you say
what you
mother
say.
In Yiddish?
Why does he keep bringing... I'm here with Simply Done, and he don't like it.
All right, listen.
You know that?
Simply Done? Is that what you call
I'm here with a guy that knows this guy, Howard. All right,
Simply
Jack,
Don.
You can talk in a minute.
Andrew Over.
Yeah, I'm here with Simply Don, and he's got something to say to you.
Why do you bring up the Jew stuff? I'm just sitting here trying to be in between, and you keep bringing up the Jew stuff.
Now,
that's
who are
wrong.
You?
Because he's
who
John.
Fred, will you address this?
This is Simply Don
what's
from
it?
MTV.
Talk to Simply Fred for me.
Simply Don from MTV.
Funny. No.
And he himself has seen the puppet come on to your wife and make advances, and you didn't.
All right, listen, I got to go. I got to go. I got to go.
You're really angry. That's why you need therapy. You
all right,
need
guys.
To get it off your chest with the puppet.
I've been working my club.
Listen, guys.
Yes.
All right, this is exhausting.
Do you think I don't have any other calls I got to make?
Of course you do.
Do you think that...
Can I say one thing?
No, yeah. Who the hell are you?
Let him say, this is Simply Don.
You're not even giving me a chance.
Why?
This is wrong.
This is not about giving anybody a chance.
No, I've paid my dues. I've opened for him.
Paid what dues?
I've worked for him for ages. Give me a chance.
Go away.
Shut up.
Who is this? Wheels Parisi?
This is Simply Don.
Who's this? Downtown Ron?
All right, listen, I'm going to go. I got to go take a break.
Downtown,
you can work
in
my
club.
Cats
hot tub.
Everybody watch.
Hot tub one.
Everybody watch Andrew Dice Clay tomorrow night on HBO.
I host
and Jackie Martling over in Baltimore tonight.
I host Silverstein.
10 p.m.
Very good.
Jackie,
you know what, Dice?
Very
if you put
today,
those CDs
in a few
in
more
oven,
years, maybe we'll get you an amateur night at the Comedy Store. And if you're any good, she'll put you on and give you the $12.50.
He can work in my club.
Nice. I'll get you a pass to the Bulldog Gym in Hollywood where you could work off that crap that's built up around your head all these years.
You can work at my club,
all
too.
All those thick cracks in your head.
Okay.
What is that?
Okay.
What are all those cracks in your head? Tell me what that is.
Nice a crack than your mother.
You're
right,
the only guy
later,
that goes to the barber to get his ear hair styled.
All right, listen.
Right, stop fighting.
It's
not good for
you. I got to go.
All right,
guess
I got to go,
having
too.
Failed at the mainstream,
wait a second.
CBS's Bless His House has crawled back to the stand-up gutter.
No, that's wrong.
Andrew Dice Clay is a witless
right, Jackie,
spew of vile sex jokes that cover every organ's
obviously,
bodily function
a man
except
that never
the brain.
Got a shot on anything in 20 years other than bringing Howard Stern his water on the set of his new movie wants to say I crawl. Dice don't crawl for nobody.
Hey, I could
Dice
buy and sell you if you weren't very expensive.
You, on the other hand, play coffee houses. You
go
play
away.
Sabaret stands on
no,
the street.
No, we'll see.
You will do any. You walk
220 seconds. We'll share the stage. You, me, and Simply Done.
All right.
Bring Simply Don and
everybody,
your manager, help you out with your act. That
bring
pig,
Hot Tub Schwartz and downtown,
pig,
downtown
that
Ronnie Weinstein with you.
Pig with a ukulele. I'll take that ukulele and shove it up your.
What do you serve? Plastic spaghetti at home?
All right, I'm cutting both of you guys off. Everybody watch Dice on HBO tomorrow night. You almost made him nuts when you started reading the review.
Take care.
He's still
I'm
talking.
Out of here.
Dice.
Over and out. Assume the position. 10 p.m. Saturday night.
Bye,
goodbye.
Dice.
Hey,
right,
Dice, I hope somebody laughs. It'll
you're
be a nice day.
Jackie,
you
ain't
going to
get it in the last 30 seconds. You couldn't get it in your own wife. That's why you're playing golf. That's the only way you're getting a hole in one, you stupid ass. You want to play with me? You want me? I'm warmed up now. If you want to go, now we'll
if
go.
That's
I'm
warmed
easy
up.
On you. I'm always
a hole
easy
in
on
one.
You. You're a pity. I give you a lot of pity. I say, this is a poor schnook walking around coffee house to coffee
hey,
house
Dice?
For a glass of Jack Daniels.
Wait,
I'm trying
wait
to
a
be a nice.
What? Robin's trying to ask
Dice,
you, Robin.
Get a,
go ahead, Robin.
If you find a positive
Robin
review, fax it over because all
women.
We've seen, we've
have
got
a little
about
respect to women.
60 faxes.
Maybe then your wife. Then maybe your wife would sleep with you.
Listen
and act
to
like
this.
You're a man. What do you put on your wife's
somebody
panties?
Somebody sent us
that's
a fax
kind of
and says
you
special's
you're
funnier with the TV off. Is that true?
What is that?
You got to be
special's funnier with the TV off.
That's you, Jackie. Beer to a
somebody told me they're
going to
turn on your special, turn the sound down, and put on my CD and see if it works.
This is so ridiculous. It's
all
like
right.
Fighting with a kid that don't know nothing.
All right. All right. Listen, Dice, right. Jackie, thank go. You. Okay, hey, bye-bye.
Dice.
Goodbye.
I'll see you on the 22nd, Dice.
Jackie, I'll see you in a few hours. All goodbye. Right.
Remember the old days when you're in showbiz.
We're going to take a break. Well, you came out of the box fighting
you
that time,
did
Jackie.
Did your job this time, Jackie. I don't think anybody could be upset with you.
All right.